Hello, hi. My name is Mariam Sakinah binti Abang Abdullah. I am the mother of Muna Raihana binti Munir Najmi. She was born with hearing impairment. All newborns have to undergo universal newborn hearing screening. During the screening, she failed her test. After discussing with my husband, we decided that, okay, we need to get a second opinion. So we came to Prince Court Medical Center and we met with the audiologist, Ms. Darlina, and we asked for a second opinion.
Hello, I'm Darlina binti Abdul Aziz, the senior audiologist in Prince Court Medical Center, and I've been practicing here for more than 15 years. A cochlear implants are for patients who have a severe to profound hearing losses, whereby hearing aids are no longer sufficient for them. Cochlear implant comprises of two separate components, which is actually an internal component. This is the coil, which is placed underneath the skin behind the mastoid, the bony part here near the ear. And also these small wires, which shall be inserted into your cochlea, your damaged cochlea. We also have an external component here, which is, this is also a coil, which is magnetic, which is placed here outside, as well as a speech processor, which processes all the sounds coming in. So how does the cochlear implant works basically? Now let's look here. Sound travels, okay, and is captured by the microphone at the speech processor. It is converted into digital information, passed along this coil, which is magnetic, and transferred to the internal component, which converts the digital information into electrical signals. These electrical signals will then be transferred to the electrodes here, this array of electrodes here, and then will be transferred to the cochlear nerves all the way to the brain. And that's how a patient will be able to hear the sound.
Masa saya kecil, dalam umur 2 tahun setengah, saya bedah pakai cochlear implant. Sebab cochlear implant ni boleh bagi saya dengar. So, masa sekarang sekarang ni dah okey lah, semua boleh dengar, boleh cakap pun semua. Saya kena latih untuk mendengar lah. Macam kalau dari jauh, kena praktis dengar lah. Kalau dengar, sama ada dengar kuat ke, slow.
You cannot expect cochlear implant to be what you call it, magic. The moment you switch on, the child will be able to talk and listen and, you know, be like normal. We came here for rehabilitation. For speech therapies, we came 3 times a week. And then I went, we went to once a week, we went to occupational therapy to help her focus more for the therapy sessions. And then once a week, we had to see Darlina to make sure that the device is okay and everything. So we had the support from the whole team. At the hospital, the therapist will assess and will teach the parents what to do.
Saya kena latih cakap dengan dengar untuk jadi lebih baik lah. Mak ngaya saya ajar saya untuk bercakap. Lepas tu, tolong saya untuk dengar. Macam bagi suruh cakap ke.
With cochlear implant, she is able to go into the society and communicate with whoever she wants. She gets the chance to be part of the society.
Prince Court Medical Center offers a holistic approach to ear and hearing care services. It is a one-stop center whereby we do have both ENT as well as audiology services. In ENT, there are both medical as well as surgical services. And for audiology, we do provide rehabilitation, which comprises either for auditory rehabilitation, such as the use of hearing aids, as well as cochlear implants.